at the Orlando, Florida. Great to be with you all again. I was thinking about the topic for today, and last week, several patients, and over the last few weeks actually, several patients have been asking me about frozen embryo transfer. You know, we've received records from patients who've had frozen embryos, and this is coming from cycles where they're getting all the embryos frozen from their stimulation cycle. And then when I talk to them about doing another type of cycle with doing a fresh transfer, they say, well, I thought frozen was better. So today we're going to talk about fresh versus frozen transfer, which one is better. So all of this started to come about from observations over the last few years in the medical literature. Studies have shown that frozen embryo transfers were giving higher pregnancy rates. But after that data was stratified and analyzed further, it seems as though there's a select patient population that will benefit from frozen embryo transfer. Okay, and who are they? Well, one of them is a hyperresponder. What is a hyperresponder? It's a patient who's on medication and that makes lots of follicles that's going to produce a lot of eggs. Well, all those follicles are going to make a lot of estrogen, and the high levels of estrogen seem to have a little bit of a negative impact on embryo implantation at the lining of the uterus or the endometrium.